Welcome back to Engineering Nature. This is Mehul. So today in this session we are going to discuss about the spray simulation, which is carried out by using discrete phase model available in Fluent. So this is the extension part of my one of the previous tutorial where I had discussed about the spray simulation without considering the interaction with the continuous phase. So what I will do is today I will show you the diesel spray simulation. These are the geometry I will consider for my simulation, having a length and height of 100 mm and 50 mm respectively, where there is a one fuel inlet from which I will supply 0.001 kg per second of diesel, which will injected in this domain, where generally I will consider this domain pressure or the pressure inside the cylinder. Generally I am considering as a one atmospheric pressure, and the fuel which is injected having a diameter of 0.18 millimeter. So my objective is to show you what happened when we are enabling this interaction with continuous phase option in the discrete phase model, as well as I will also explain what are the input parameters when we are defining the injection property in the discrete phase model. So this is the similar geometry which I had created in my previous tutorial. I am using similar mesh. So you can visit that tutorial before you go to this tutorial. I recommend that. So let's start with this problem. Initially I just imported that problem. So these are the inlet, outlet, as well as a wall which I had created in the previous geometry sections. Simply you can check the mesh, you can change the scale. And I'm going to consider transient flow simulations for getting a good animations of this spray. Now you should set the physics. There is a no multiphase over here. So in the viscous, you simply select K epsilon with standard options. Our intention is to understand discrete phase model. So you go to the discrete phase options. Now in the discrete phase options, you have to select this interaction with continuous phase, so which is not the case in one of the my previous tutorial. And you should also select unsteady particle tracking. I'm injecting the fluid particles at every time step size of 0.5 microsecond. The total tracking parameter you should set as a 50,000. Your step length factor should be 5. Now you have to enable the breakup mechanism to for droplet breakup, as well as enable the child particle tracking. Now let's set the injections property through diesel injections. I already said that, but let me show you what are the parameter which I had considered. I am considering plain orifice atomizer for injecting this diesel. You consider 500 number of stream to track the particle. Now once you add the diesel liquid in your material library, this options is visible over here. Our flow rate, diesel flow rate will be, I'm considering 0.001 kg per second, as well as the injected flow having a diameter of 0.18 millimeter. Remaining parameter you just kept as default as it is. For the breakup, I'm going with KHRT spray model. You just cap all default constant. You should also enable the discrete random walk module. So these all are actually the setup which I had choose for my breakup simulations, spray breakup simulations. Once you set all, you just simply, I said that in the material sections you have to add the diesel liquid prior to this DPM model. So then only this inert, see in this inert particle we have that diesel liquid which I already selected from this Fluent database. You just go to the Fluent database and just add that whatever liquid you want to inject, whatever fuel you want to inject. So there are gasoline or there are a diesel which is available, so you can select from this Fluent database. Now once you add that material, obviously that same material we had choose for our DPM selections, You can also change the property as you wish. Now let's close this window and let's move to the boundary conditions. Now in the boundary conditions, I see that it's a stagnant 1 atmospheric air which is inside the cylinder. So that air generally you can specify it by mean of cell zone conditions. So we have air inside this cylinder domain, and that air having a pressure of almost 1 atmospheric pressure. So in the boundary condition, I will just supply inlet as well as outlet boundary condition, which is I select as a pressure boundary condition. So at the inlet, I just choose the pressure inlet as a 1 atmospheric or 0 gauge pressure. In the same way, for the outlet also, I will define 0 gauge pressure as a pressure boundary conditions. Now, and what I will do in the inlet as well as in the outlet, in the DPM selections, I will select the escape discrete phase options. And let's specify a turbulent intensity as well as hydraulic diameter accordingly. Same way in the outlet, I said that you just define 0 gauge pressure, as well as in the DPM selections, you just go through this escape option and 5% turbulent intensity with 50 mm of outlet diameter. That is my outlet parameter. Now simply you apply all these boundary conditions and just go to the in the wall sections, which is wall of the cylinder. In the wall sections, you have to activate in the DPM sections, that is the reflected boundary conditions. This is how you have to activate the reflected boundary conditions. So all spray particle will reflect from the wall. Now once we define all boundary settings, you simply close that and go to the solution methods. You can keep a default solution method, there is no issue. You can set the residual, what accuracy you required. So I just cap default as it is. Now in the report sections, in the report definitions, you can define certain parameters which you want to track during the iterations. So let me define a new parameter, like it's a penetration length, which I want to plot during the iterations, during the diesel injections phenomena. So this is what report definition I had defined. You can define any parameter which you want. Now you simply initialize hybrid initialize and run the calculations. I am going to consider my time step size of 0.5 microseconds. I already conducted the simulation, so I will show you just 10 number of iterations with this time step. And for each time step, intermediately I will consider 20 iterations for 0.5 microseconds of time step. So once you click on the calculate, obviously in the console we can see the number of iterations is going on. Since in the report definition we already defined the penetration length, which will calculate it throughout the iterations. At the same time, in the solution activities, I had enabled this spray image, DPM spray image. So during the iteration, it will continuously reflect it. So after, I think 3000 iteration, I wish to stop this simulation, and I will show you the post-processing part. I again advise you to go through my previous tutorial where I didn't activate the continuous interaction with continuous phase. Initially you can inject the fuel particle without interaction, and then in the later stage you can enable in this way also. So now total 83,000 particles which I had injected during this much of time period. So it's a 0.00825 seconds. So let me show you certain results. First, let's look into the velocity contour, because it's a fuel which is injected into the cylinder. So in the very center portion, we visualize the magnitude of that fuel. So apart from that, you can see the discrete phase variable. So these are the fuel which is distributed. Now it's better to visualize through the particle tracking options. You go to the particle track and simply just display the particle track. So it will give you complete information how the spray particle will distributed into the cylinder or during the continuous phase interaction options. So this is how you can visualize the spray pattern. You can find the penetration length as well as cone angle from this spray image. Now let me show you third parameter, that is a setter mean diameter. You just go through the report and calculate the summary in the diesel injection system. So once you click on the summary on the console sections, you have entire summary which will give you plenty of information, numerical informations which involved what is the total amount of mass which is injected, what is the total area or volume covered by mean of this spray at the, and very much important, that is the sature mean diameter, that we can find out from this summary. So this is the animation which I had captured during the 3000 iterations. That's it for this sessions. You can write queries, comments on this video tutorial. So I hope you will be having idea about spray simulation with the use of DPM in the Fluent. So stay connected. Thank you very much.